Welcome to the best of BCAN 2019. We made it, guys.
Yeah.
We're down at the Heights in downtown Toledo. I'm your host, Allie Ray of Arts Now, and I'm joined with a couple familiar faces. We have our food man, Tim McMahon of Four One Nosh right over here. Yes. We have my co-host of Trending Toledo, Jordan Tomasi. Also producer and host of Rise Up, Eric Oblander. And Marcus Harrison, our executive producer of BCAN.
Hey,
the man that makes it happen.
Good to see you, boss.
We are so excited to recap everything that we've been up to this last year, and let's start it off with Eric Oblander, producer of Rise Up. Rise Up is such a diverse music show. What goes into all this?
So, Rise Up, you know, when I started Rise Up, I told the producers, I'm never gonna run out of stories,
music stories
in this town. There are so many great bands, great musicians, you know, cool things happening around. So I really don't run out of stuff in this town. It's so easy, so much great music in this town, so many great musicians, so many innovative musicians. Endeavor ends, it's super diverse, everything from, you know, from heavy metal to polka to hip hop to ambient. I mean, we've got it all here, and it's a great town to work in.
And one of your favorite segments, and also mine as well, is the polka story that you did here at the Renaissance where we are today.
Yeah, when I started the show, I had a very short list of things in Toledo, music-related stuff that I wanted to eventually cover. On the top of that list was a band called Polka Motion, Toledo Polka Motion, a band that's been nominated for Emmys. They've been in, you know, movies with like George Clooney and stuff like that, and they're from right here in Toledo.
You know, really what hooked me on the music at 16 years old, I took a trip out to Seven Springs over the 4th of July, and every year they would have a six-day polka festival, and I went out there, and from that moment on I was hooked. There was like 30 different bands and jam sessions all over the place, 3,000 people a day attending the event, and from that point forward I was hooked.
I found out they were doing a big polka festival here in the building, and I found out that the guy that was running the whole thing was in Toledo Polka Motion, so it was perfect.
It's great that you not only highlight Toledo music, but also you're not afraid to travel, especially with Four One Nosh and One Tank Travel host Tim McMahon.
We're travel buddies.
Yeah, Tim and I work together on a lot of stuff. It's a lot of fun. You know, I work with all you guys at some point or another, but Tim and I do a lot of stuff music related. You know, I'll drag him out with me too if I'm doing something like at a record store or whatever. And one of the things that we did was the One Tank Travel, where we got to go to Detroit. And that worked out pretty cool because Tim and I were at Culture Clash Records filming a separate story, and I just happened to randomly pull out a piece of vinyl, and he and I had been kind of kicking around ideas of where could we go with One Tank Travel. And I pulled out this vinyl, and it was an album by my friend Todd Albright on Third Man Records, and he's from Toledo. And I thought, you know what? This is where we go. We go interview my friend Todd.
This is a big secret. There's a lot of things on the 12-string guitar that you can do that you can't get away with on a 6-string because it would sound ridiculously simple.
Right.
But when you're doing it on a, you know, a low-tuned 12-string, it sounds pretty meaty, you know.
And you just blew it. You told
everybody. Yeah, I told everybody. I've been running around telling everybody everything. I don't know what's wrong with me.
It worked out great. The Third Man people were super gracious. They let us film in the building, and we made a day of it.
We got a lot out of that. That
you
was on 419
really
by Design.
You guys squeezed every last drop out of that.
Yeah. We did a tour of the plant for 419 by Design, which we'll get to later. We got to do some stuff for his show, and I got to interview Todd and kind of talk about his career, being from Toledo, but you know, being an artist on, at that point, you know, the biggest record label in the country.
So how did One Tank Travel start out?
Well, One Tank Travel was sort of birthed from this brainstorming sesh that I had with our executive producer, Marcus Harrison, way back in January of this year.
Yeah, we sat down and, you know, we put our heads together and we just kind of came up with this thing. I mean, when you started 41 Nosh, it was like, you know, who doesn't love food?
Yeah.
You know, and it just kind of took off, and it just made like more sense to just, let's make this thing bigger. How big can we make this? So we decided to, you know, like expand our footprint a little bit, and it just made a lot of sense.
Yeah, because obviously, you know, everything we talk about is focused in Northwest Ohio and ties to Northwest Ohio. But we thought by taking it on the road, because we are sort of at the crossroads of America, literally, at least in the Midwest with 75 and then Turnpike, everything's within driving distance. Detroit's an hour, Cleveland's a couple hours, Columbus 2.5 hours, things like that. Even Chicago is only 4 hours away. So it's a way to go to these restaurants and in these venues like Third Man Records, where we're on the road, where we got Toledo ties like Todd Albright or even Eric himself. So I always go on the road with somebody from around here. Danny Rogers over at Sports Nightly. We went to the University of Michigan because that's where she went to school, in Ann Arbor.
Did you work game days in college?
Yes.
For this university?
I got a phone call from Coach Harbaugh's assistant. So Coach Harbaugh came in, my...
Coach Jim Harbaugh,
correct? Coach Jim Harbaugh. Okay.
We're name dropping now.
Yes, we're name dropping. Yes, Coach Jim Harbaugh. His assistant called me. He's like, I've seen everything you've done with men's lacrosse. I was a student manager for them, picking up lacrosse balls during practice.
Yeah.
And then I was working for the Big Ten Network Student U. He's like, come help us. I'm like, I don't know what that means, but yeah, sure, totally. I'll go work for Jim Harbaugh. So that's how it started, sophomore, junior year. I was only here for a semester senior year. Kind of took a step back and kind of enjoyed my senior semester. But yeah, game days were khakis, polos, every day at the bakehouse.
And with you and Jordan and Trending in Toledo, we did a fun little wine trip to
so
Firelands Winery.
We made it to Firelands Winery. You guys ready? We'll do a little tour.
Yeah, ready.
Maybe
go.
Try the charcuterie and meet the crew here and...
Cheese and wine?
Cheese and wine!
Yes!
All right, ready? One, two, three, bring it in. Wine!
Wine!
In Sandusky.
I felt super left out of that.
Oh,
you didn't.
It wasn't
you
that
didn't
much
miss.
Fun.
Oh, yeah, no. I mean, it might be biased, but it was my favorite out of all of them. Sorry, guys. But Tim, you've been to so many places and you've eaten such amazing food. What's been your favorite segment?
That's tough because I get this question a lot, and food's so diverse. So it's like, how do you compare like best pizza to like best burger and things of that nature? But one of the favorite segments that I had this year was with Taco Gringo. They park down at East Washington and cheer on. It's like a party every time you guys got to come next time.
I mean, our energy here is just wild and crazy. We love what we do. This is the way we do it. It's all about, you know, all love. That's how everything comes out.
Maybe my favorite moment of the year was a story that you kind of approached me with, Jordan. Sierra Grounds Coffee House in White House. We were thinking of ideas for our Be the Change campaign in October, which is anti-bullying and celebrating inclusivity. And so we went out to this coffee shop. You joined
Speaking
me,
of collaborations,
Allie.
Yep, I'm usually always behind the camera for Four One Nosh.
Yeah, and vice versa. I help shoot Arts Now as well, but we went to this place. They hire people with disabilities, or as they like to say, people with varying different abilities.
You never know what you're going to get when you walk in the door. We have over 50 clients that rotate through our doors every day. We have an average of 5 or 6 every day with us. They each bring their own skills and personalities to the business, and you come in and you see it. You might see Richie behind the counter and he's pushing sugar on every customer that walks in, or Tommy G that wants to hug everybody before they go. So it kind of just depends on when you stop in, who you're going to work with.
And they have great coffee and great food as well. So I mean, that was a topper.
You brought back some of the best pumpkin cookies I've literally had in my life. They were so melty, so gooey. So yeah, we have to go back.
I think
soon.
Tommy had his hands in those because
yeah.
he
well, Tommy
puts a lot
is
of
a pro.
Yeah,
I feel like that story really, you know, captures the spirit of this city, where we're very inclusive, we're very innovative, and figure out great ways to kind of put those two things together to fantastic results.